photo editing battle, me versus artificial intelligence.
I think that this is an excellent lens.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Emmett, and professionally, I'm a software developer, but my spare time, I love making landscape photography and related videos here on YouTube. And today, I'm going to take a look at editing a photo that I took last week, and I thought that I would show you actually editing this photo a couple of different ways. First, in my preferred editing software, Affinity Photo, which is how I actually did edit it for the video that you saw last week. And then second, I thought that I would take a look at it in Luminar Neo, which is a very interesting photo editing tool that uses artificial intelligence to make editing your photos a lot faster. So here is the photo that I will be editing, and I will put a link up here to the video from last week in case you missed it when I took this photo. You can go back and catch that. But this is the photo that I took, and I picked this one of the three that I took just because it's in the landscape format, and so it fits a little bit more nicely onto the screen to take a look at. And this is the raw file opened up in Affinity Photo with no edits applied here. And so I'll go ahead and show you some of the ways that I edited this. Now I do want to mention that I already edited the photo for last week's video and put that in there, so what I get today may not look exactly like the final result from last week. And also, I may not do all of the same things. Usually in these editing videos, I will omit a few of the kind of medial steps that are a little bit boring, so that, you know, I'm not just boring you guys. So the first thing that I did with this photo was it really needed some major color correction, because it was, you know, it was really golden hour, it was towards sunset, and that does not come through in the raw file. The photo here is very white looking, and so I just took the white balance and turned it way up, something like that. And then I also turned up the saturation and vibrance just to really give it a much more golden and colored feel. And then I actually tinted it toward red just a little bit too, because it seemed very slightly green. Then the next thing that I did was it seemed kind of dark actually. And so just turned the exposure up a little bit, not too far because I don't want it to be really bright, but a little bit brighter. And give it some more contrast as well. I mentioned in the video last week, I really like high contrast photos, and I was not kidding about that, so turn up the contrast a little bit there. And then finally, it's a little bit soft. Raw files do not have the same sharpening applied to them that JPEG files do. And so you would expect them to be a little soft, and you do need to sharpen them. And so what I did was I just pulled up the clarity some and went to the details tab and pulled up the detail refinement some as well, just until it looks sharp. And then with that, we can go ahead and hit develop. And now what I want to do is remove some fringing. I don't know if you can see it here, but if I zoom in on this corner, you can see there's a lot of this blue and purple fringing around the trees here because they were very heavily backlit. And so to do that, just open up the defringe filter right here and select the color of fringe that you want to remove. And since I have two different colors of fringe here, I can just add two different filters if I need to. So, and I'll turn the tolerance up a little bit to get a bit more Command J duplicates that layer. I can open up the second one and pick the blue color. And now the branches look black again instead of having blue and purple fringe on them. Now, last week I did do a little bit of refinement on some of the smaller details in this photo. So right here on the trees, there's some red blazes. I spent a while removing those. And then in kind of these logs here and the path where there are highlights, I actually enhanced those highlights a little bit. But primarily, this is really what I did to get the look that I wanted on this photo, was mostly that white balance, saturation, exposure, contrast, straightforward things actually, to take it to this really nice gold look. And so now I thought that I would take a look at this in Luminar Neo and see how I might edit it over there. And so right here we have the same RAW file opened up in Luminar Neo. And the first way that I could edit this would basically be to just do exactly the same things that I did in Affinity Photo, but in Luminar Neo. And so there's this develop option right here. I could select that. And I could just go through and hit the temperature, saturation, vibrance, contrast, which is actually smart contrast over here. It's not entirely clear what's smart about it. And the exposure, maybe a little more, something like that. So there's original and now. And if I look over here, it's fairly similar. I think I put a little more contrast on this one. But you get the idea. I could do basically the same things over here that I could do in Affinity Photo. But what I thought that I would do is kind of show you the more sort of luminary way of doing this with some of the tools that are unique to this editing software. Now, if you're not familiar with Luminar Neo, there's kind of a little bit of controversy around the Luminar software lineup, which uses artificial intelligence to kind of make editing your photos really easy and really fast. There tends to be a lot of controversy around photo editing anyway, because everyone sort of has their own opinions about whether you should edit your photos at all, how much you should edit them, what's allowed. And honestly, I tend not really personally to care that much. If you get something that looks nice at the end, if you've made some art, that's cool with me. But there is some controversy around this software just because it makes some edits so easy and then also allows you to do some kind of dramatic things, like in the older version Luminar 4, which I also have, there was an option in there to let you add things into the sky, like you could add a hot air balloon into the sky from their like photo library using their AI stuff. It dropped it into the sky, and it's a little dramatic. I don't tend to use those sorts of features though, because I don't really like to edit a photo too much beyond the light and color in the photo, because I'm really kind of trying to document something that I saw. And so even when I do edits like this to pull up the temperature and the saturation and things, a lot of that is really about kind of documenting the world as I saw it. I might enhance the color a little bit and things to pull the, you know, the mood across, but I try not to do anything too crazy. However, there really are tools in here that are very helpful for that kind of photography as well. So what I might do if I were to be editing this photo here is go to this landscape section and just pull up the golden hour slider. It was golden hour in this case. You can also use this to make it look more golden if, I don't know, you maybe missed golden hour or something. And then I'll also pull up this foliage enhancer slider. And this is something that I like a lot because it uses artificial intelligence to really find the foliage in the photo and make the leaves look kind of greener and more saturated, which is really very helpful. You could do something similar with like an HSL adjustment in Affinity Photo or whatever, but it's just really easy to do it like this. And so I might pull that up a lot as well. And then if I wanted to adjust the lighting in this photo, there is a relight AI option right here. And this lets you adjust the brightness in kind of the foreground and background of the photo, as well as change the temperature of that lighting. Apparently there's some kind of like 3D mapping artificial intelligence going on in the background. I don't really know what's going on, but it does seem to work pretty well and be a powerful tool as I've been kind of looking at it. So I could turn up, if I turn up the brightness in the front a lot here, you can see it kind of lights the bottom. It almost looks like a light was shining from the camera there. And so for this photo, what I might do is maybe adjust the line between foreground and background a little bit, pull the lighting up and warm up that lighting tone just a little bit on the far out lighting, but warm up the close up lighting more, maybe something like that. And so you can see this was what it looked like before I did that, and then here's after I did that. So it really kind of brightens it up and makes it a lot warmer and things, similar to what you might do with exposure adjustments or something. You can also definitely do different lighting in different parts of your photos using layer masks in other applications, but Luminar just makes that really kind of fast and easy for you. And then one final thing that I thought that I would take a look at, just because it's kind of cool, isn't something that I really would probably use in my photos that much, but you can actually add sun rays to your photo. So there's the sun rays section here. You can place the sun in the photograph and increase the amount. I'll be a little dramatic with it just so you can see it well. And what's cool about this is that it actually uses the artificial intelligence to pick out the things that are in the photo and take them into consideration. So if I move the sun around, you can see that it actually goes behind the tree here. And so the sun rays adjust to the trees in the photo. If I move it behind this big tree over here, the sun rays are kind of here and there, but the sun has been blocked out by the tree. Same thing in these trees over here. It peeks through the bright spots, but it's blocked by the tree. So that's really kind of cool. And you can actually, if we make some adjustments and turn it down a little bit, maybe make it a little warmer, you can actually make fairly realistic looking sun rays in your photograph. If that's something that you wanted to add in. I don't really tend to add sun rays to the photo. You can actually get them fairly easily by letting the sun peek into the camera lens a little bit. It'll usually make a kind of sun ray effect on its own. But it is a pretty cool, powerful feature that I find really interesting. So just to talk about Luminar Neo a little bit, I have noticed that it lacks some of the more powerful features that you would find in other photo editors. So for example, the fringing in the top corner here, there's no way in Luminar Neo that I know of, at least, for me to actually get rid of that. It does not have a defringe tool to remove that purple and blue fringing. Now, I'm not really sure that I would actually want to really see a defringe tool or something like that in a software like Luminar, because so much of the focus is on the artificial intelligence. I don't want to get into dragging those individual sliders for things and getting into those finer detail edits, because if I'm going to do that, then I could do that in another software like Affinity Photo or Photoshop or something like that, that's really designed to do those things. In Luminar Neo, what I really want to see is some kind of adjustment that automatically takes care of some things like your sharpening, your denoising, your defringing, that sort of thing. Those menial tasks that you do on a lot of photos, I think that some kind of automatic adjustment would be a really nice addition to the app. In my mind, the software like this, I think, is really for when you want to edit a bunch of photos fairly quickly. And that's why, for me, I tend not to use it as much, not because I don't like it, but just because I usually only take a few photos. Like my last photo shoot, I had 3 compositions when I got done. And if I've got 3 photos, I just want to spend a little bit more time on them in Affinity Photo. That really allows me to do some of those more kind of fine-tuning, detailed edits. And you can't really do those as much in a software like Luminar Neo. It's really designed for you to let the software take control more. Even though you can do some things with like masking and such in here, it's not designed for that in the way that Affinity Photo or Lightroom and Photoshop are designed for that. And so I think that this is more for if you've, say, gone on a vacation, you come back, you've got hundreds of nice photos that you want to edit to do a photo dump on social media or to put it in a photo album. You just want to make them all look a little nicer. This is a really, really good way to go through a lot of photos at once and get them looking nice really quickly. So I think it's very interesting, it's very cool. It's not my go-to editor, but I do actually really like it. I'm intrigued by it. What I would really like to see from them is actually a mobile app, because I could see this being really nice for those mobile photos that you want to make look nicer really quickly with a couple clicks of the button, and you want to kind of quickly post them on your social media or something like that. So I'm interested to see where this sort of technology goes in the future. So anyway, that is all for this video, but if you have some thoughts about photo editing, AI photo editing, either of these softwares, whatever, feel free to leave a comment and let me know. If you did like the video, don't forget to hit the like button on your way out and to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss more videos that I'm really excited to share with you guys in the future. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.